Hey guys, Peter here to do an album review. Today I'm here to tell you about the latest from Sweet Oblivion Relentless, out April 9th on Frontiers Music. This album has 10 tracks, 42 minutes in length, and this is the band's second full-length studio album. They are a hard rock, classic heavy metal band featuring Jeff Tate on vocals, former Queensryche lead men. Now, this album has a very fluid structure. It really connects the songs well, and I think it's because of two separate elements. The soundscape that it has, it's very uniform across the whole record. There are some deviations, there are some slight changes, but there's a lot of the same elements permeating from one track to the other, allowing that soundscape to stay almost intact as you progress through the record. The other aspect that allows this album to be very fluid is the individual song structures that it has. Those song structures are very similar at times, and they allow the album to have this sense of continuity from one track to the other. You feel like you've been there before, you feel like you have an idea of what's coming around the corner. When you put these two elements together, you have an album that really doesn't offer a lot of deviations, that keeps you on your path, that keeps you moving forward from one song to the next, allowing you to stay engaged with the record from the beginning all the way to the end. Having said all of that, there are some speed bumps along the way. This is not a record where every song sounds exactly the same, where you're gonna get the same look, the same feel, track and track again. They did a wonderful job alternating styles and alternating songs in order to create some, like I said, speed bumps along the way. So you're gonna have some songs that are more melodic, more hard rock, if you will, then you're gonna have some more classic heavy metal sounding tracks, then comes in some songs that have more of a ballad kind of approach. So all of these things allow the record to have different changes or very slight deviations, if you will, from song to song in order to keep you going, in order to keep you moving, in order for you to stay engaged, staying looking forward to what the next track is going to offer while still enjoying the one that you're in. Once you move into the soundscape, this album is crisp. Really well recorded, really well executed. You can feel all the different elements coming together, regardless of how the songs are put together in terms of the genre that inspires the output of the track. It doesn't matter if the song it's more of a hard rock track or a classic heavy metal track. The soundscape stays very uniform in the quality of delivery. You're gonna hear the drums, you're gonna hear the bass, you're gonna hear the guitars, and you're definitely gonna hear the vocals. Everything is coming at you in its own lane, working in separate ways, so it's easy for you to digest and process all the different elements that make up the songs. But at the same time, it's also easy for you to bring them all together and really understand what the track is trying to do, where it's trying to take you, and what it's trying to deliver. So this is a very well-recorded album that has a very clean, crisp soundscape that's very powerful in the sound, that works as individuals, but at the same time, it works as the collective as well. Now, within that soundscape, there are three elements that deserve some attention for different reasons. The first one being the bass. I love the bass sound on this record. It's not a driver of the experience of the album, it's not a driver of the overall soundscape, but it plays a very important role, specifically on songs that create a huge divide between the verses and the chorus. Coming in the verses in a part of the track that's perhaps a little bit more subdued, a little bit more stripped out, the bass creates a little bit of foundation. It adds an incredible solid pillar in which the song can then be built from it. And it also adds some grooviness, it adds some atmosphere, all important elements. And I like the fact that it's in the forefront, it's not hidden. On an album like this that's perhaps driven by the vocal approach, and we're gonna get into that, the bass is perhaps seen as an element that doesn't have a predominant role or is just gonna be there because it has to be there. I felt that on this album they really used it, and they used it in the right amounts, in the right spaces, in order to create something different, and in order to give something that perhaps the album was lacking. Next is the drums. The drums play an important role, but they play also in a way that are never really pushing themselves into the spotlight. And I feel like perhaps because of that, the bass plays more of a role than the drums do, or becomes a little bit more noticeable as you're listening to this record. The drums are there, but they're just there. I never really felt that they pushed themselves or that they created volume, they created heaviness, they created presence, and some tracks really called for it. And I felt that they were a little bit flat overall when you look at every single track on this album. There was room for growth, there was room for bigger sound, and they were just there kind of treading water, creating a solid foundation, but not something spectacular. And that's perhaps the reason why I like the bass so much, because it kind of filled in the gaps in the songs where the drums were not completely full, if you will. Now, the guitars have a driver moment within this record, within certain songs, but they also sit on the passenger seat for a lot of the tracks. So they have this duality of roles, and this duality of roles is something that really puzzled me as I progressed through the album. I wasn't expecting the guitars to drive the experience, because that is the role that I want for the vocals. But I was expecting it to be more of a parallel role, or at least in some songs, to see the guitars shine, come up to the podium, take your 5 minutes of fame, if you will. And while on some songs that happens, specifically in the solos and in some of the leads, on some other tracks, the guitars almost disappear in the overall soundscape that the track holds. It becomes very difficult to really notice what the guitars are doing or exactly where they're trying to take you, because they're just like the drums treading water for huge portions of the tracks. So I would have liked to see the guitars be a little bit more consistent from that perspective, because the quality is there. When you hear them, you hear them, you feel them, and you can see the strength, you can see the presence, you can see the power that they hold. But on some tracks, I felt like they pulled back a little bit. Perhaps due to the construction of the songs, going from more of the heavy metal, classic heavy metal sound to a more hard rock approach, they felt the need to take a little bit of the edge off of the sound of the guitars. I don't think you need to do that, regardless of the genre, regardless of the style, but that's exactly the approach that they took, and I felt that it fell flat a few times, and it took a little bit of the sting away from some songs. And then it gives the album a little bit more of a push when you get into a track where the guitars are a little bit more on the forefront, that play more of a larger piece of the puzzle. So a little bit disappointing from that perspective. Then you get into the vocals, and the vocals is the piece of the resistance as far as this record is concerned. The vocals lead the record. They are the record. They are everything that this record is really about. Jeff Tate is on full display. This man is vintage, and once again, vintage performance across every single track on this album. This is not a record where I felt that he took a one style approach. That's really not his DNA anyways. But this album, he worked with the record, he worked with the tracks, and he gave each song a similar output as far as quality is concerned, is leveled across every single song. But as far as the tone and delivery goes, he tried to match the songs, he tried to match the intensity, but giving each one of them a different fingerprint, if you will, as far as his voice goes, really using his pipes as another instrument and not just as a vocalist. He goes a little bit beyond what you would expect, allowing this record to be centered around his voice, around his vocal performance, and that becomes the beacon of the album. He dictates where the songs goes, the feeling of the tracks, the atmosphere, everything comes out of his voice, out of his vocals, and what he can do with it. Another element surrounding the vocals that I felt was really interesting was using some backing vocals, sometimes in the verses, very rarely in the verses, but there's a few occasions, sometimes in the pre-chorus and then obviously in the chorus. Every time that they came on, these backing vocals, it really worked. It created volume. It didn't really make the songs heavier, but it created volume. And for someone that has the range that he has, it allows them to go in one direction while using the backing vocals, bringing the song in a complete opposite direction. So there's this duality of approaches that works really well, making the choruses and the pre-choruses a little bit more catchy, a little bit more hooky, and when used in the verses, bringing a little bit of darkness and atmosphere to the song, emphasizing the mood that is present within the lyrics. Overall, I really enjoy this record, and if you're a friend of Jeff Tate, you have to listen to this album. I mean, this is his record. He just destroys this album vocally. He puts everything that he has on the table, shows you exactly what he can do, how you can use your voice as an instrument from the beginning all the way to the end, changing ever so slightly, creating moods, creating atmospheres, changing the directions of the songs and the direction of the record as you progress through it. He is the beacon of this album. Around him, I felt they could have done a little bit better. You don't have to outshine him in order to really make this album sound bigger, but I felt that the drums and guitars at times had too much of a subdued role, and I wanted them to be not on par with his voice, but at least getting almost there. In order for the overall album to have a little bit more substance, to have a little bit more soul, and perhaps not to feel as fabricated as it does in some of the songs. Now, as far as favorite tracks are concerned, I want to start off with my favorite song on the album, Wake Up Call. I just love this track, and I love how it sounds, I love how it comes across. Having the bass in the verses adds that foundation that I was talking about earlier. It really helps the song move along. because the verses are a little bit more subdued, a little bit more stripped out. Then once the chorus hits, the chorus is so big. It's big musically and it's big vocally. It just has a lot of volume, a lot of melody, and it becomes super catchy and super hooky, allowing you to really gravitate to it. So when you're in the verses, you're always waiting for that chorus to come around the corner to win you over. It's the kind of song that has that momentum, that has that style, that has that approach. Super incredible track, vocally, musically, the movements that it has, the different directions that it gives, the structure of the song is perfect. I just love how this song is put together. My favorite song on the album. Next, Anybody Out There. This one has a little bit of a heavier riff as far as the guitars are concerned. Comes in with a little bit more power. Still a lot of melody, but there's definitely a little bit more power. Has more of an old school approach to how it opens, specifically how the guitars come in and they set the tone at that opening section of the song. That is definitely an old school approach, but I really like it because it fits the mood of the track, it fits the mood of the record, and it definitely fits Jeff's vocals once they come in into the song, balancing everything out. The backing vocals in the chorus add a little bit of depth. I didn't feel like they gave the song extra heaviness, but they definitely gave something, gave more substance to how that chorus comes across, allowing it to be even more hooky, even more catchy, just by using those backing vocals. And that's an important element of this track. The solo is outstanding, really showcasing the talent of the guitar player, what he can do, what he can offer, and that's something that's true throughout as far as guitar solos are concerned. There was never a solo on this album that you felt that he was mailed in. This one is one of my favorites because I felt like it really matched the intensity, it felt like it matched the momentum of the track, and it had that old school flavor that was present in the guitar opening of the song, then it comes back again with the guitar solo, so it goes almost full circle. Last but not least, Fly Angel Fly. This is the last song on the album. The song where I felt that the guitars pushed themselves almost into the spotlight, sharing that spotlight with Jeff Tate's vocals. This song feels more robust. It feels more together. It feels more balanced. It has a different structure from the two previous songs that I mentioned. And it's a song that has a little bit more layers. It has a lot more depth. You can feel the keyboards, you can feel the bass, you can feel the drums, but the guitars are shining above everything else as far as the soundscape is concerned. Really dictating the pace, dictating the direction of the song, and then Jeff coming in with his vocals and just confirming that's exactly where you need to go and that's exactly where you're gonna be going with this track. So overall, I wish more songs had this approach as far as construction is concerned, but also as far as the soundscape goes, because they feel more organic, it feels more natural, it feels fuller. This is Sweet Oblivion featuring Jeff Tate on vocals with the brand new album, Relentless. Once again, out April 9th on Frontiers Music. Let me know your thoughts on the band, on the singles. Use the comment section below. I'll be reading those and getting back to you. Take care, guys.